We're here at the Glee Show, which is a trade show for the whole world of gardening and everything that goes with it. And part of the Gardening Times is linking with Sutton Seeds and their fantastic new range called the Homegrown Revolution. It says what it's on the packet, what it does in the tin. And lucky enough to be standing here with James, who is launching with Sutton's this fantastic range. I got very excited the other day when we met up, James, and you actually gave me an electric daisy, which made the whole of my mouth go, how did the electric daisy become on the list?
Gosh, well, I started out with things that I thought were exciting to eat. Yep. So I started out, there's roughly 3,000 edible crops to be grown in the UK. And every gardening book since the war has talked about 20. So we're really growing 0.01% of the potential to be grown in the UK. So I started out looking at this big old list of all these wonderful things I thought were really exciting to eat, that fancy chefs are using, that you have to go to, you know, to fancy central London food halls to get hold of. And then I worked back to see what we could actually grow. I trialled it over 3 years. An electric daisy, I thought it was brilliant. I mean, there's plenty of much more conventional things like sweet potatoes and kiwi fruit and tea. The electric daisy, though, is if you want to grow your own spices and not just fruit and veg, it's fizzy, space dust-like sensation. You know, growing your own popping candy in a beautiful daisy.
Absolutely. So you've got the visual ornamentation of it, as well as something extraordinarily culinary. Wow.
Well, as gardens get smaller, you don't have space to have them, you know, you'll grow your own relegated to the back of the garden by the greenhouse and the compost bins. If you've got a tiny roof terrace, your plants need to look as beautiful as they taste.
Yes. And within the Gardening Times, we're starting the apotment. And we're going to be actually trialling these this range and some other Sutton seeds within the apotment. So keep watching the space. But James, your interest in plants started, like me, a long time ago, I think, didn't
you? Yeah, it's very sad. I think certain of us are born with a geeky gene that sort of kicks
in. Or just the green and the dirt between the nails.
Well, the sad thing is, I've got the geeky obsession with it. I don't have green fingers or green thumbs.
Right.
I really need to try to get stuff to grow to work. And for ages, it's been a negative thing for me. However, doing a trial, it's brilliant. Because anything that I can grow means anyone can grow. Because, you know, I only can spend 2 to 4 hours a week on my plot. I don't have a greenhouse, I don't have a team of staff, it's all done organically, and I don't cost it things. If they work for me, they'll work for anyone.
And that really is an important message that Sutton's want to get across, and certainly at the Blackwood Gardens we want to get across, is that anyone can have a go at growing these plants. You don't need huge amounts of space. We're going to be growing in containers, hence the word apotment. And so with James's help and Sutton's help, we'll be following this through for the next long period of time. And to support all that, James, you've got a brilliant bestseller that's just come in.
I could have even knocked 50 Shades of Grey off the top seller list briefly, but it's still got there. And I think it shows a lot about how excited Brits are about the possibility of growing your own. You know, growing your own is a boom as it is, even though what generally most people end up growing is the allotment equivalent of powdered eggs and Spam. You know, it's really growing a wartime staple. British food has become so more exciting in the last 60 years. We've taken ideas and ingredients from all over the world. And my book really just starts to show you the beginning of the possibilities that you could grow. You know, you can grow goji berries, you can grow kiwi fruit, you can grow yams, you can grow sweet potatoes, you can grow electric daisies. They're like proper meat and two veg, not just weird hippie food that anyone can grow and you'd have to pay a fortune for if you could find them in specialist retailers.
Absolutely. But you're not saying don't grow the potatoes and the range. This
growing
is a long
potatoes
side.
Is brilliant. If they work for you, then that's fantastic. But we're constantly growing the same 20 things. There's no point in me telling you how to grow a potato because everyone else will tell you that. Google grow your own potatoes, you'll get hundreds of thousands of hits. This stuff is about everything else that for some reason no one's ever mentioned.
Absolutely. And that's a great note to finish on because this is an exciting range of plants. Keep an eye on the website and the magazine, and hopefully you will also get some tips as to what James has been saying, and get excited about growing plants, and surely that's what it's got to be all about.
That's what it's all about, plants and the food mainly. I think the food gets me more excited than plants. It's just plants are a fun way to get there.
Good point. Don't forget to eat it. But then, James, thanks so much. Good
to
see you.
Great to meet you.
Thank you. The packet says it's an electric daisy with a taste of electricity. I'm going to put that to the test. I can certainly feel something. I'm pretty sure that's an acquired taste. It's certainly great fun. And James was telling me earlier that it's quite a long-lasting effect, so I may have to go and have a lie down.